What's up, guys? Sean Nalawani here, seannal.com, bodytransformationtruth.com, answering a nutrition question today. It's one that I've gotten several times over the past few months, and that is, do incomplete proteins count as part of your protein totals for the day, and do they contribute toward muscle growth? So the short answer here is yes and yes. Every gram of protein that you eat throughout the day does count toward your protein total, whether it's 25 grams from a chicken breast or 1 gram from a banana. And yes, incomplete proteins do assist with muscle growth as well. So for those who don't know, a complete protein is a protein source that on its own has a sufficient proportion of all 9 of the essential amino acids that your body needs for proper health. And the essential amino acids are the ones that your body can't make on its own, and so they have to come in through your diet. On the other hand, incomplete proteins are protein sources that are low in at least one of the essential amino acids. Complete proteins generally come from animal sources, so meat, eggs, dairy, etc., whereas incomplete proteins come from plant sources, so bread, pasta, rice, vegetables, etc. Now, the reality here is that almost every food that you eat is technically complete because it does contain all 20 of the amino acids in some amount, but it's just that certain foods will be particularly low in at least one specific essential amino acid, and this is usually called the limiting amino acid in that food. For example, beans are high in the amino acid lysine, but are low in methionine, whereas grains are high in methionine, but are low in lysine. Now, keep in mind, it's very important to understand that rather than thinking in terms of your protein intake being broken down into complete sources and incomplete sources, it's more useful to think in terms of just total amino acid intake. And that's because all proteins are ultimately broken down into those individual amino acid building blocks for use. And so as long as you're consuming enough total protein for the day as a whole, and my general recommendation would be between 0.8 to 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight daily, as long as you're eating around that amount, and you're eating a standard fitness diet that includes a variety of different protein sources, then the idea of complete versus incomplete protein really just becomes a non-issue, because by the end of the day, you're gonna be getting in all of the amino acids that your body needs to maximize muscle growth anyway. Your body can only build so much muscle in a given day, and it only needs a limited quantity of each of those amino acids to max out your growth potential over any given period. And so it's not as if just eating higher and higher amounts of complete protein, it's not as if that's necessarily gonna improve your results. Your body can only use so much. If you were only eating a very small amount of protein relative to your body weight each day, so let's say you were eating for some reason 0.4 grams per pound of body weight, and let's say that you were only getting that protein from one or two primary sources, then yeah, it definitely would become a problem because certain amino acids wouldn't be there in high enough quantities to maximize protein synthesis. But as the total quantity of protein that you're eating increases along with sufficient variety, this becomes proportionally less and less of a concern because your total intake of each specific amino acid is going to be increasing along with it. And then on top of that, your body also has what's called the free amino acid pool. And so if certain amino acids are missing at a certain time when they're needed, then your body can draw from this pool in order to make up for it. So the bottom line here, yes, so-called incomplete proteins definitely do count towards your daily totals, and the amino acids that they provide do contribute toward muscle growth as well. Remember that they still do contain essential amino acids, but it's just that they'll be low in maybe one or two of them, and each different source will be higher or lower in different essential aminos. And so when you start combining them together in the big picture, it's really not something to worry about. Guys, if you found this advice helpful and you want to get all the tools you need to gain muscle and lose fat as effectively as possible, the workouts, the meal plans, supplement guides, along with one-on-one coaching, then you can download my body transformation blueprint by clicking here or by heading over to bodytransformationtruth.com using the link in the description box. If you enjoyed the video, as always, make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on future videos. You can also check out my official blog over at seannal.com for all of my latest updates. And you can follow me on social media here if you aren't already. The links for that are also in the description box. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll talk to you again soon.